Dude, get over yourself. How many times have you heard someone say that to you? Get over yourself. Well, they're actually quoting Catholic doctrine, or a Catholic spirituality, where we learn to have a certain disinterest in who we are. And today we got John Leonetti, who's written the book, The Art of Getting Over Yourself. We'll be right back with a Bear Wozniak adventure.
Welcome to the Bear Wozniak adventure. Kickstart that engine and roll thunder with the pack. Explore the grittiness of manly spirituality. Gain traction in the virtues. Soup up your spiritual engine by turning adversity into adventure. Now here's Bear Wozniak. Let's ride.
He said it to his disciples. He says, if you want to come after me, if you want to be my disciples, you now will take up your cross daily and follow me.
I don't
and,
get to take know, a day I, off.
You don't get to take a day off. And look, I get it. Like, you know, we sit in mass and we hear the words from proclaimed, you know, from the deacon or the priest of the gospel. And, you know, sometimes we're thinking about other things or sometimes we don't quite catch something. I can't be clear enough. The apostles, they understood deeply what the Lord was communicating to them because they knew what the cross was. They knew what it symbolized.
And it symbolized what? What does it?
This was Caesar's rule. This was his reign. This is the cross was the greatest force of execution that the Romans could implement, and they surrounded. I mean, they lined the streets with crucified. With the crucified. I mean, in fact, it was so gruesome that they would stake. They would say guards by these crosses as people were hanging from these trees because the people that were hanging from the trees would be begging bystanders to kill them, to shove spears
right.
into their hearts.
Right.
So the guards, they wanted it to last as long as possible. So on average, about 24 to 48 hours. It was the most excruciating form of death penalty. Such a moving, powerful figure in Christianity, but in the world. Would say such a thing. What he had to see was incredible. That was another teaching moment for him. Mm. It was all about God. You know, it was not about him. Everything was oriented towards God. Everything was in service towards God. That's where he found who he really was.
Yeah, you and that's why I said when I was having that prayer experience, I couldn't add or take away from anything other than just the word you.
Mm-hmm.
It just comes down to who God is. Can you back up a little bit with us and tell us about that type of experience in your own life? How do you pursue intimacy with God?
Prayer every day. There's nothing more important than making time for God in our day. And that's how you spell prayer, T-I-M-E. You said something that was perfect towards the beginning of this segment. You said that you don't do this to ourselves. We don't make ourselves saints. Sanctity happens from God. Pure and simple grace, right? Grace.
Hey, man, I don't want you to miss out on your free stuff at deepadventure.com. Go there and subscribe to our weekly email newsletter. You get free video content, including the Bear Wozniak radio show, video version on YouTube before it even airs on EWTN. And you can follow us on all of our social media. Go to deepadventure.com and subscribe. Plus, good stuff happens when you support us at patreon.com/Bear Wozniak Deep Adventure. You get instant access to every radio show, Bear Wozniak Adventure, and our TV episodes, Long Ride Home, the instant we produce them, months before they even air. Plus, we give you all kinds of free stuff, coffee cups, t-shirts, and other things like that. Go to patreon.com/Bear Wozniak Deep Adventure and become our patron. If you're watching on YouTube, don't forget to press the subscribe button and ring that bell.